All right. So 10th class, we were discussing about the online fraud. Okay. Now the concept is, what is HTTPS? HTTPS, S means secure connection. Right. I want to access any website. I type the URL. A connection is built with the me and between the server. The connection should be encrypted connection. It should be safe connection, and that is ensured by HTTPS. If S is not there, simple HTTP is there. It is basically a protocol. When you type the URL, suppose I type www.facebook.com. Every URL has three parts: type of protocol, HTTP, name of the server, facebook.com, and then the location of the file. So HTTP basically is a protocol that helps us to access the web pages. But when I am using HTTP, I am not under secure connection. It may happen that my IP address, my location may be shared with a third party sitting at the remote area. Okay, so it is always recommended that try to do private browsing or do browsing in the incognito mode. The incognito mode is a mode of browsing where your IP address, your location is not shared with the third party. No cookies are created. Cookies, you know, temporary files. Okay. So when you are doing the incognito browsing, you are in the safe browsing. Your information is not shared with the third party, right? Am I clear? Now the next concept is secure data transmission. Now by name, it is very much clear, secure data transmission. I am sender, Arman is receiver. I want that if I am sending message to Arman, the message should reach to Arman safely and securely. The data in between should not be compromised. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि इन बिटवीन चैनल पे कोई हैकर है और डाटा मेरा हैक हो गया, मिसयूज हो गया. ओके, सो व्हेन द डाटा ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम सेंडर टू द रिसीवर, द डाटा शुड नॉट बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. नोबडी नो एनी मालवेयर शुड इंटरफेयर इन बिटवीन एंड ट्राई टू हार्म द डाटा. So we are to protect our data, and what are the techniques by which we can protect our data? First is SSL. SSL stands for Secure Socket Layer. Secure Socket Layer basically is a protocol that help us to establish the encrypted connection between the server and the browser. Tarundi, please pay attention here. Okay. A secure and a safe connection is created between the server and the browser. Might you have seen this term many times when you start WhatsApp chat, sometime you receive the message, end-to-end encryption is done. Means when you are chatting with your friend on WhatsApp, your chat is safe. It is encrypted. No third party is interfering in between. Okay, clear. Second technique is data encryption. Basically, what is encryption? You're not comfortable at the back, Sash. You can come in front. Come here. So data encryption means that sit here. I want to send data. Okay, I will change my original message into some code. Right? I have changed my original message into some coding. Right? And that coding technique is only known to me and to the receiver of the information. If in between any hacker or any malware try to attack the data, try to attack on the data, he won't be able to crack it. So my data is safe. When the data will reach the receiver, he knows to how to break it, how to again convert the code into original message, which is called decryption. That is called decryption. Converting the original message into coded form is encryption. Again, reconverting the coded form data back to original is called decoding, decryption. Okay. So only sender and receiver knows how to encrypt, how to decrypt. Okay. Use safe protocols. Just now I tell you about HTTPS. Do check whether the URL contains HTTPS protocol or not. Okay. Intellectual property rights. On this, if you people have a view of CBSE sample paper, which was uploaded last year, there was one case study on the topic secure data transmission. There they have introduced some short numerical mental ability questions also, which I'll be discussing tomorrow in the class. Okay, so all of you have to bring the rough notebook with you. Tomorrow we'll be solving some mental ability questions. Okay. Now, intellectual property right. Any information, I create one topic. मैंने एक essay लिखा. उस essay के ऊपर मेरा sole right है. I am the creator. I am the owner of that information. सहर्ष ने कोई मशीन बनाई. इसने एक मशीन इन्वेंट की. सहर्ष इज द रियल ओनर ऑफ दैट इन्वेंशन. लीगली इट इज अप टू मी हाउ मच इंफॉर्मेशन आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर विद अदर्स. आई मे शेयर, आई मे नॉट शेयर. If I am sharing, how much charges, how much price I will charge in return to that? Then if I am sharing, up to what extent I am sharing? Am I sharing complete information or am I disclosing only the relevant facts? This I have to see. This whole comes under intellectual property rights. These are the rights of the owner of the information to decide how much information is to be exchanged, shared, or distributed. Plus, it gives the right of the owner, the right to the owner to decide the price for doing so. Agar woh exchange kar raha hai, वो इसके रिटर्न क्या प्राइस चार्ज करेगा. ओके, नाउ हाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट योर आईपीआर. आईपीआर कैन बी प्रोटेक्टेड इन थ्री वेज: पेटेंट, कॉपीराइट, ट्रेडमार्क. अभी जस्ट आई गिव यू वन एग्जांपल अबाउट सहर्ष इन्वेंटिंग अ मशीन. सहर्ष कैन गेट द मशीन पेटेंट. Patent is always granted by law on some invention. आपने कुछ invent किया तो उसके ऊपर आपको law patent provide कर देता है. Limited period of time के लिए, उसके बाद you have to renew it. I wrote one book. मैंने एक book लिखी और उसको मैंने publish करवाया. On that book, I have my copyright. Again, law gives me this facility, this right, because I am the owner of that book. I am the creator of that book. So by law, I have provided the rights of copyright on it. You people download something from net or from YouTube. Okay, you develop some page in which some YouTube matter is there and you upload it back on the YouTube. They will put the copyright claim error. When you will upload it, you will get the message of copyright claim. Because you are not allowed to upload something which is copyrighted material. So copyright is on the art, any literary work, any creative work. Okay. I purchased one mobile of Apple. She purchased the mobile of Vivo and she purchased the tablet of Samsung. Every company has their fixed logo. Apple ke phone ke piche wo Apple ka logo bana hota hai. Vivo ka apna logo hai, Oppo ka apna logo hai, Samsung ka apna logo hai. Har company ek registered mark lagati hai apne products pe. That registered mark is used to distinguish one product of one company with other company. You can differentiate that, yes, this is Apple brand. Yes, this is Samsung brand. This is Nokia brand and this is Vivo brand. This is Vodafone SIM card. This is Airtel SIM card. So that is trademark. Registered logo. That helps to differentiate between the products. I give one live example to you. Swami Sanda School has their own logo. Aapke blazer pe bana hota hai logo. Aapke tie pe, belt pe. Okay, if you purchase the copy of the school, to school ki copy pe bhi registered mark hota hai uska. Then MGN has their own logo. APJ School ka alag logo hai. Innocent Heart ka alag logo hai. Guru Amar Das School ka alag logo hai. This logo differentiate each school differently, uniquely. Right? So in these three ways, you can get your IPR rights protected. So what is patent? It is a right granted by the government to the inventor, giving the owner the exclusive right for making, for selling his invention for a limited period of time. He can sell the machine. He has the right because he is the creator of the machine. What is copyright? It gives the creator of original work exclusive right for a limited period of time, and copyright is always applied to creative, artistic, and some intellectual work. I may publish the work, I may sell the work. And how the copyright is shown? Small c in the circle. And you have created a symbol in web pages also in PT1. Ampersand copy, semicolon. You remember? Now, why IPR rights must be protected? IPR rights ko protect karne ki hame kya zarurat hai? Why? What are the reasons that we need to protect our IPR rights? We should encourage the individuals, all the citizens, all the businessmen to create new softwares and to modify the existing ones. Whenever you download something from the Play Store, you might have noticed after a few days, you get the updation message. Isko update karo. Why we update? Raise your hand for the answer. Online class, you can also raise your hand. Why we update it? Yes, Navnesh. So that it can incorporate the recent changes being done in the software. Am I clear up till here? Simarleen, Sahaj, Japjot. Japjot Singh. Okay, so one thing is you develop new software. Second is, if you have already developed the software, renew it, refresh it, make new changes into it. Sorry. Aaj ek mobile aaya market mein. Suppose Oppo Reno 4 Pro. Suppose after a month, you will get the advertisement on the television. Oppo Reno 6 aa gaya bhai. So we people think, yaar mujhe wo lena chahiye tha. Main thodi wait kar leta. Technology is not static. ये नहीं कि आज एक चीज इन्वेंट हुई है तो वो लगातार चली जा रही है, वही चली जा रही है. टेक्नोलॉजी कीप्स ऑन चेंजिंग डे बाय डे. इफ वी गो सेंचुरीज बैक, इयर्स बैक, दैट सिंपल नोकिया फोन वाज एट द आई पीक, 3310 मॉडल, एंड वी वर फीलिंग वेरी सरप्राइज कि हाई इसके पास 3310 मोबाइल है जी. बट नाउ नोबडी हैज दैट मोबाइल. Nobody talks about that product. Everybody wants to have touch phone and with all the latest features. Now the 5G is launching. Okay. So technology is not static. It is changing day by day. Whatever the needs of customer are, we are to study the need of the customer. Customer kya chahta hai? उसी के अकॉर्डिंग कंपनी को अपने प्रोडक्ट्स बनाने चाहिए. ओके, नाउ कम्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, सूट्स ऑन यू पीपल, प्लेगरिज्म. सिंपल, आई गिव वन लाइव एग्जांपल टू यू, कॉपी द वर्क. यस, ऑनलाइन क्लास. Am I clear the meaning of plagiarism? Copying the work. Sahaj Preet is first to raise the thumb. Stealing of the work. More appropriate term, if I say. And presenting the work as if it is your own. But actually, it was not yours. Like Karan Jyot is approaching Himanshu every time. For the file. So when we steal the work done by others and present the work that we have done this work, that is called plagiarism. In simple terms, you can say stealing someone's intellectual work. Now, these are the situations in which we say plagiarism has occurred. It can come as MCQ. Pick out the statement that identifies the act of plagiarism. Or read the following statements and tell which cyber ethic has been taken place. Using some other author's work without giving credit to the author. You have taken someone's work, but you are not mentioning the source. You're not writing the name of the actual person to whom that work belongs. Using someone else's work in incorrect form. What actually was the work? You change it into some incorrect form and present it. Changing the original. Modifying someone's production without attributing it to the creator. Somebody created some product and you are modifying it. You are changing it. Giving incorrect source of information. काम मेरा था, सहर्ष ने किसी और का नाम लगा दिया कि उसका काम है, उससे लिया. He didn't mention the real source, the actual source. Failure in giving credit for the contribution of others. Might be that work has been created by teamwork, but no credit was given to the team that who all contributed this work. So all these situations, they are examples of plagiarism. how to avoid plagiarism. If you get a theory question, what is plagiarism? Definitely you'll have this question associated, how we can avoid it. Or it can be MCQ form or case study form. How to avoid plagiarism? Cite the source. Cite means mention the source from where you have taken the data. Like these days, I'm reading some workshop PDFs. So the creator of the PDF, he has mentioned clearly that this topic has been taken from Wikipedia. This has been taken from this website. Clearly, they have cited the source. So that is not plagiarism. Include quotations of another person actual spoken. Day before yesterday, only yesterday only I was giving example to you people that in your science book, some definitions are there given by the researchers, and that definition is always enclosed in double quotes because that is the actual words spoken by that scientist or any other person. Aap English ke thoughts dekh lo. Agar koi famous poet koi thought deta hai, wo thought bahut popular ho jata hai. So always that thought is written in double quotes. Okay, am I clear? Using a plagiarism checker, there must be a check applied. Might be any software you can use that should check that whether the work has been plagiarism or not. Right? All right, questioning round starts. Just raise your hand online and offline. Fraud occur on internet is called dash. Navneet, online fraud. Dash and dash are two types of fraud.
Credit card fraud and
identity theft and credit card. Okay. Act of stealing someone else's intellectual work is termed as A option, IPR rights, B option, fraud, C option, plagiarism, D option, privacy.
C option,
plagiarism. Okay. Which statement is true with respect to avoiding of plagiarism? A option, cite the source. B option, enclose the statement into double quotes. Third, use a plagiarism checker. D, all above.
All above.
All above. Keeping personal information confidential and hidden from the outside world is termed as dash. Encryption is converting into code. I'm saying keeping my personal data hidden. I'm not disclosing my details with you. I'm keeping my details hidden.
Privacy.
Privacy. Law, rights granted by the law in the case of invention.
Patent.
In the case of artistic and literary work.
Copyright.
Registered symbol or any logo that distinguishes product of one brand with other.
Trademark.
Full form of IPR. Intellectual property rights. Three ways by which IPR can be protected. Three ways by which we can protect IPR. Tarundi. Yes, who will tell? Three ways by which IPR can be protected. Just now, students, they give the answer. Patent, copyright, trademark. Okay.